lose it again. I'm about to let them know where I'm from. Don't take me there again. Just call on Jesus, my friend.
Good afternoon, LJ3. This is Pastor E here. I'm excited to be with you again on this Sunday afternoon. I'm especially excited because we're starting a new series. If you was with us on Wednesday, I gave you a sneak peek into the series that we're starting. We're starting a new series, and it's called Be Great. That's the new series we're starting, Be Great. Listen, if you remember back when we were having, right before back to school rally and everything, I told you there was three things I was expecting of everybody, and I've been reminding you each and every week of those three things. One, I'm expecting you to be the example. Two, I'm expecting you to be great. And three, I'm expecting you to trust in God. But these are all pertaining to just school. So what I thought to myself is, I want to also tell you why it's necessary for you to be great, not just in school, but in every walk of life. So for these next few weeks, we're going to talk about being great, and we're going to talk about being great in specific areas in your life. So today, our first part of this series is calling Be Great, dot, 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 at home. Be great at home. And so if you would turn with me in your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 6, the first verse, Ephesians chapter 6, we're going to read verses 1 through 3. And it reads like this: Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with the promise that it may go well with you and that you may live long in the land. Right there. So our title is Being Great at Home. And we're talking about right there, honoring and obeying your parents. So this might be one that your parents are excited about, want to have you sitting and listening to, because they've been trying to get you to listen to them for months, for years, and you still ain't at knucklehead and you ain't listening. So this is the one I want you to hear from me. It's about obeying your parents and being great at home. Listen, I love this text, because what this text does is it tells you exactly what the Lord expects from you. I told you this before. What I love about the Bible is that it's not confusing. It doesn't try to trip you up. It tells you exactly what's expected of you, and then it's your responsibility to follow it. Listen, so it says right there in verse 1, children, obey your parents as you would the Lord. Is right. It's what it's saying. Obey your parents as you would the Lord, because this is right. You should, number one, want to obey your parents, number one, because it's the right thing to do. That's what God is saying. It is the right thing for you to do, is to obey your parents. Your parents have been placed in position to lead you and put you in a position to be successful and to grow in your relationship in Christ, to grow and mature it as you get older. And it's your responsibility, because it's right to obey them. And listen, the first thing I want you to understand in this is you're supposed to honor and obey them without any conditions. That's the first point I want you to get, without conditions. Because a lot of times what we do is we decide we want to honor and obey God and listen to him and follow his words when it's convenient for us. And we take that same obedience to God and turn it over to our parents. When our parents are, when we feel like obeying our parents, we do it. When they're making the right choices and decisions that we feel are right, we do it. But what I'm saying is, this Bible says you are supposed to honor your father and mother no matter what the conditions are, no matter what they do. It didn't say honor your father and mother if they're a good father and mother. It didn't say honor your father and mother when they do everything you want them to do. It didn't say honor your father and mother when they do everything right and don't make it. And even when they make a mistake, it's saying for you to honor your father and your mother. This is what you're doing to obey the Lord. You're doing this to please God. And see, he says honor your father and mother. He didn't put anything in front of it. Because what we'll sometimes do is, if we feel like our mom and our parents are tripping, we're going to trip right with them. If we feel like they're not doing what they're supposed to do, we're going to trip right. We're not going to do what we're supposed to do. We're going to use what they do in their actions as a reason to why we make the choices and decisions that we make. But see, that's not what the Bible tells us. It says strictly honor your father and mother, period, point blank. He didn't put any stipulations around them about what they do. He says, I'm talking directly to you and what you should do. And what I'm telling you is, I need you to be great at home, because it's the right thing to do. You're supposed to do that as you're supposed to obey the Lord. He's saying, just like you obey me, that ought to be the same thing you do to obey your parents. There should be a direct correlation between the way that you obey me and the way that you obey your parents. If you are obeying me and doing what I say to do, but not honoring and obeying your parents, God is saying, I'm still not pleased because you're not doing what I asked you to do. You're doing part of it. I'm happy that you're obeying me, but I'm not happy that you're disobeying your parents. And so I need you to honor your parents despite what they do, despite how they act. It is something that you have to do. And listen, they didn't put even an age requirement on it. I am a grown man with a family of my own and kids of my own, but I still have to do this by honoring my mother and my father. I do it for as long as I'm living and as long as they're alive, I'm going to make sure that I live a life that honors my mother and father. Why? Because it's what I'm supposed to do and because what the word is saying. And what I don't want you to do is to miss out on blessings because you decide that you want to be disobedient. Listen, this isn't just about honoring your parents and doing whatever your parents tell you to do. This is about being obedient to what God says to do. And if anything what I'm supposed to do as your youth pastor is lead you in that right direction. And so what I'm saying is I need you to be great at home, even when you don't feel like it, even when it doesn't make sense to you, even when your parents are working your nerves. We talk about it even in the middle of this pandemic when you have to be at home with them all the time. Schools are shut down. A lot of you are in virtual learning right now. You've been cooped up since spring break, since March in the house with the parents and you don't feel like it. But your job is to honor them no matter what. That's the first thing. Honor them without conditions. The second thing is God honors your commitment. That's number two. God will honor your commitment. When you honor your parents, your mother and your father, God will honor your commitments. Why? Because he says it right here in his word. It says, honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise. It is the first commandment that gives a promise to you. And what is that promise? So that it may go well with you and that you may have long life in the land. That's two blessings right there. That's promised. There's two blessings that come with it. So not only is it just right, he didn't have to give you any blessings. He could have just said, obey and honor your mother and father because I said so, because he's the Lord. And because he's Lord, we're supposed to follow what he's supposed to do, point blank, period. But he says, if you honor your father and your mother, what I'm going to do in return, because I'm such a good God, is I'm promising you two blessings. The first blessing is that it may go well with you. That it may go well with you, that you'll be blessed, that you'll have a good life, you'll have blessings upon blessings, and things will go well with you in your life. That's what he's promising you. And what you'll notice is if you're not honoring your mother and father, that means that, and you're wondering why things in your life aren't right, why things seem upside down, and why you feel like things aren't going the way that you would like them to go, it might be because of the way that you're disobedient to your mother and your father. Have you thought about that? I've said this before. How much is your disobedience costing you? We've talked about that before. How much is your disobedience costing you? How much is your disobedience keeping you from what God has for you? He said that it will go well with you if all you have to do is honor your father and mother. He's promising you these things. This is a promise. This is coming from the Lord. He's saying that even if your parents don't honor your obedience, even if they don't honor you listening to them and honoring to them and being obedient to them, God says it's not about them. The way that I'm not blessing them, you're not going to be blessed based on what they want to do. You're going to be blessed because I promised you you'll be blessed. That's what should be your motivation. Not what are my parents going to do. If I'm obedient to them, are they going to do this? Are they going to let me have certain things? Are they going to bless me with certain things? No, that ought not be your motivation. You should want to honor them because that pleases God. And because that pleases God, God turns around and he goes and he wants to bless you. That's what he wants to do. That's why he makes this. This is a promise that he's making you. And you have to understand is God's ability to bless you isn't predicated on anybody else. He's not depending on anybody else to be able to bless you. No matter what anybody does, he's going to be able to bless you. Why? Because he promised it. It's a promise that he gave to you that it may go well with you. Not only that, and will go well with you, that you may live long in the land. So he's saying that your obedience and honoring your mother and father also determines or lengthens my life. Yes. Do you understand what it's saying? That your disobedience may be taking days and weeks and months off of your life, all because that you're being disobedient. That's the second promise, is that he'll make your days, it says he'll have a long life. Your life will be extended based on your obedience. He's saying that if you are obedient to my will, if you're obedient to my word, and you honor your mother and father, if you do those things and be great at home, not only am I going to bless you and you're going to, everything's going to go well with you, doors are going to open up for you, God's going to just pour out blessings on top of blessings for you. He's going to give you the things that you want and the things that you need. Not only that, he says, I'm going to do it for the length of your life, and I'm going to extend that life so that you can enjoy it even longer. Look at that. This is a direct correlation in what the reason why you should be great. You should walk away from this message today saying, you know what? I'm going to be great. Why? Because this obeys God, that it may go well with my life. And number three, that my days will be longer, that I'll live longer on earth. It's so crazy. My grandmother, we talk all the time. I try to call her every week. And when we would talk, she would always tell me, be obedient to your mother and father. Since I was a small kid to growing up, she says, oh, be obedient. Are you listening to your mother and father? Are you listening and doing what they say and do? Are you being obedient to your mother and father? And I never understood until I read this text why my grandmother told me over and over and over again, always asked me, am I being obedient? And she would get on me if she ever heard I wasn't being obedient. I didn't understand why that was so important for her, but she says she had to tell me that because she wanted to make sure that my days are long on this earth. She didn't want me to miss out on days and forfeit months and forfeit years and weeks of my life just because I didn't want to listen and do what my parents told me to do. And that's what I don't want you to do. Hear me. That's why I said the first part is not about your parents, because you're sometimes not going to feel like it, but you need to do it because this directly affects you. Your ability to honor your mother and father directly reflects you, nobody else, you. And so if you want to sit there and give all the excuses, well, my pops did this, my mom did this, ain't no way I was going to go for that. I had to keep it real. You're going to keep it real. You're going to keep it 100 enough to where you're going to wonder why your life ended early. And God is saying, all you had to do was be obedient. I had blessings for you. I was going to extend your days, but you decided to keep it 100. Because you didn't want to honor your mother and father because they weren't doing things that you thought were that you were supposed to do. So what did you do? You canceled out and you shortened your life because you didn't honor them like the Bible told you to. The Bible's cut and dry here. It's really simple, y'all. This message is not very long. It's cut and dry because that's what I want to tell you right there. Honor your father and mother. Listen, I don't be great at home. This is an easy thing for you to do. And for that, to know that there's promises coming your way, that God says he's promising this. If you honor your father and mother, he's promising these things will happen, that it will go well with you and you may have a long life in the land. He's promising you this. This has to be something that you take into account. And being obedient and honoring them at home does not just mean in the physical home. That means as since you're living with them, when they're not around, when they're not watching you, are you doing things that they're telling you to do? Are you acting and doing and the things that you're doing when they're not looking at you directly? Does it reflect how they raised you? If it's not, you're not honoring them. Every time I left this house when I was a kid, I remember I was in high school, I get ready to go out and go see my friends. My dad would remind me. He would say, remember your name. He says, I've lived a long time building up my name. I have a good name out there. Don't go out in one night and mess up my name. Because he says, if you go out and you do things out there that that don't look like the way that they've raised me, don't look like the way that they brought me up, and go against what they've taught me and what the word says, then now I'm dishonoring them. And so when I'm telling you to be great, I want you to be great, not just inside the house when I say at home. I'm saying that when you live at home, you are still under, when you leave you leave the house and you go out and you with friends and you're in other places, the things that you do, you need to honor them there as well. Be great everywhere. Don't make mistakes, because not just because it doesn't please God, because it doesn't honor your parents. And what I'm saying is, God is saying that if you're going to sit there and disrespect them after I'm giving you these promises, I'm going to cut these promises off from you because of your disobedience. So I'm telling you, honor your father and mother, because number one, it's what pleases God, and number two, that you're going to be blessed by it. God will honor your commitment to honor your parents. He just will. Last thing, I talk about this because, and we said the first point is how you honor without conditions, no matter what your parents do. Your job is to honor it, because God is saying that I'll take care of the parents. Let's look at verse 4. Look at Ephesians 6, verse 4. It says, "Fathers, don't stir up anger in your children, but bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord." You see, this is what I talked about. What God would do is, God says you to honor your mother and father. I told you, he said without any conditions, because it's not upon you what you think they should do for you to honor them. It's to be, God is saying, I'll take care of addressing your parents. I just need you to honor them. I'll take care of getting them right. If they don't do right, if they do wrong by you, it's on me to take care of them and not you. You see, we're not good enough to make the decision on whether our parents make the right decisions or make mistakes in our eyes and decide whether we're going to honor them or not. We're just not that good, because it could be something simple. You get mad if they punish you for you messing up, if they don't let you go somewhere you think you want to go, or give you a curfew and tell you to be home. You might think that's bad enough for you to sit up there and be disrespectful to them. But God is, see, that's not what God is saying. God is saying, if they're not doing right, if they're not bringing you up in the right way, it's on me to deal with them, not you. Your job is to honor them. And if you do that, I'm going to honor you, like we just talked about in point two. But he says it right here. He says, don't stir up anger in your children. He's giving them direct instructions as well. God's not just instructing us to honor the parents and be great and at home and to honor them and obey them. He's telling them, don't stir up anger in your children. He's telling them, but bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. He gives them the steps of what they should do and what they shouldn't do. Don't stir up anger, and bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. And if your parents don't do that, it's on God to deal with them and not you. It's on God to deal with them and not you. God will handle your parents. That's why I said you honor them without conditions. That's what I love about the Bible and why it's so simple. Because you're sitting there trying to find every reason to why. Because you could sit there and tell me, Pastor E, I ain't really with you today. I hear what you're saying, but you know, I try to honor my parents, but they be tripping. And when they trip, I start tripping too. I'm telling you right now, God is saying he don't care. And if they trip, what they got to do with what I told you to do? If they tripping, what they have to do with you? Nothing. Nothing at all. It has nothing to do with you at all. He says, honor your parents. My promise is I'll bless you, and I'll give them instructions and deal with them if they don't do right by you. But your job is to honor them, because what happens when you honor them, that just gives God promises to just send blessings your way and extend your life. That's what's gonna happen if you honor them. He promises it in his word. It's a promise in his word. We just read it. That's why I need you to be great at home. It's because I want to see you get every blessing that God has for you, and I want to see you not to lose any of your days on this earth. I don't want to see it happen. And so it's important that you be great at home just as I told you a few weeks ago, to be great at school. And honor your mother and father. Remember, honor them without any conditions, number one. Number two, God will honor your commitments when you honor your parents. That's what God will do. And then number three, God will handle your parents. He says it in his word. He gives them instructions on what they're supposed to do. And if they don't do it, let God have to deal with them while he's blessing you. Bow your heads for a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, most gracious God, we thank you, God, for your word. That your word promises, God, that if we honor our father and mother, dear Heavenly Father, God, that you'll make things go well with us. You'll extend our lives on this land. God, I ask right now if there's any people struggling right now with their relationship with their parents, so much so that it's even pushed them into the position where they dishonor them, God, to change and turn their heart, dear Heavenly Father, to learn, teach them to honor their parents, God, understanding and knowing that you blessed them, that the promises you gave will not be void. God, begin to touch the heart of the parent, dear Heavenly Father, in that relationship and strengthen that household, even right now, dear God, so that they know, dear Heavenly Father, God, to bring them up in the instruction that you give them, and God, for them to know to honor their mother and father despite what's going on. God, touch those situations, touch those individuals, God. Help us each and every day, dear Heavenly Father, to be more like you, to be more obedient to your word, to your will, and to your way. It's in the mighty Master's name of the Master we do pray. Everyone said, amen. Listen, I hope y'all listen to me, listen to this message. Be great. It was short. It was simple. It was right to the point. But God's word does not lie. It is right there. Come on, just honor your mother and father. Let's start being great at home. All right. Listen, couple announcements. I am so excited about when we get back together in church. I miss you guys so much, but you know, we're being safe, we're being cautious, but when we do come back, I can't wait to be inside our brand new youth area together. Listen, now, even though the church has been closed, work has still been getting done inside this church. So listen, we're gonna have our own area. It's gonna be beautiful, it's gonna be wonderful, it's gonna be state of the art, it's gonna be everything you want and more. Listen, I can't wait to be with you then. Until then, we will still be having Bible study every single Wednesday at 7 p.m. Listen, the link does not change. Every week, it's the same Zoom link. You don't even have to wait to get an email or a message from me. Just find the last one I sent you if you can't see the new one and click on it, and we're going to be there every Wednesday at 7. Don't miss it. I love it. Put your cameras on so I can see your face, because I miss each and every one of you. Also, I thank God that we got over this storm, that the storm passed by us in Houston. But if you have any family that's in Louisiana, we are continually praying for them. Let us know if there's anything that your family needs or could benefit from. Let me know if they're going through anything. Let me know. But we're praying for everyone to the east of us that were hit by this Hurricane Laura. But make sure if you have anything, come back and come see us. Now, listen, I want to see your faces on Wednesday. Don't disappoint me. Let me see you on Wednesday, because I really do miss you. And not only do I miss you, I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. God bless. Have a good one.